Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kandan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on solution and discussion on the mechanical engineering subject. And this is lecture number 40. We are going to discuss heat exchanger. The questions, gate questions in the topic heat exchanger in this lecture. The first question from 1991 question paper. In a shell and tube heat exchanger, baffles are mainly used. There are four answers: to increase the mixing of the fluid, increase the heat transfer area, deflect the flow in desired direction, reduce the fouling of the tube surface. And this is the shell and tube heat exchanger. The tube side fluid, it is flowing inside the tube, and we have shell side fluid, and there are baffle plates. So the baffle plates are provided to deflect the fluid in desired direction on the shell side. So the correct answer is deflect the flow in desired direction. The second question from 1994 question paper. The practice of use of steam on the shell side and cooling water on the tube side in condensers of a steam power plant is because option A, to increase the overall heat transfer coefficient, water side velocity can be increased if the water is at the tube side. Condenser can act as a storage unit for the condensed steam. The rate of condensation of the steam is invariably smaller than the mass flow rate of cooling water. It is easier to maintain vacuum on the shell side than the tube side. Among the four answers, the most appropriate correct answer is, it is easier to maintain the vacuum on the shell side than the tube side. So we have to maintain vacuum in the shell and tube heat exchanger. So in the steam power plant, the condenser is operating at lower at vacuum pressure. So it is easier to maintain the vacuum on the shell side than the tube side. That is why we are using steam. We are circulating steam on the shell side and cooling water on the tube side. Next question from 2002 question paper. For your same inlet and exit temperatures of hot and the cold fluid, the log mean temperature difference, LMTD, is greater for parallel flow heat exchanger than the counter flow heat exchanger, greater for counter flow heat exchanger than the parallel flow heat exchanger, same for both parallel flow and counter flow heat exchanger, depending on the properties of the fluid. The correct answer is greater for counter flow heat exchanger than the parallel flow heat exchanger. So we will see how the explanation in the next slide. So we have heat transfer in the parallel flow heat exchanger equal to heat transfer in the counter flow heat exchanger. So the heat transfer is UALMTD. So U is the overall heat transfer coefficient, U into AP, area of the parallel flow heat exchanger, LMTD of the parallel flow heat exchanger. Similarly, UACLMTD of counter flow heat exchanger. Now for the same overall heat transfer coefficient, AP LMTD of parallel flow heat exchanger, AC LMTD of counter flow heat exchanger. So rearranging, AP by AC equal to LMTD of counter flow heat exchanger divided by LMTD of parallel flow heat exchanger. Now we know that the area for the counter flow heat exchanger is less than the parallel flow heat exchanger. So the area for the counter flow heat exchanger is less than the parallel flow heat exchanger. So the ratio AP by AC is more than 1. So, if the ratio on the left hand side is more than 1, the right hand side also should be more than 1. So, for more than 1, LMTD of the counter flow heat exchanger should be greater than LMTD of parallel flow heat exchanger. That is the answer. So, LMTD of counter flow heat exchanger is greater than the LMTD of parallel flow heat exchanger. The next question from 2011 question paper. In condenser of a power plant, the steam condenses at the temperature 60 degree Celsius, the cooling water enters at 30 degree Celsius and leaves at 45 degree Celsius. The LMTD of the condenser is, we have four options, we will select, we will find out. The correct answer is 21.6 degree Celsius. So we will discuss the solution in the next slide. So this is the temperature profile of the condenser. So the condensing fluid temperature is the same, THI equal to THO. The cooling fluid is entering in the left side with the TCI and leaves with the TCO. The given data, the hot fluid saturation steam temperature is 60 degree Celsius, TCI 30 degree Celsius, TCO 45 degree Celsius. theta I, temperature difference on the left side, THI minus TC equal to 30 degrees Celsius. Theta O, temperature difference on the outlet, THO minus TCO equal to 15 degrees Celsius. So, LMTD is theta I minus theta O divided by logarithmic of theta I by theta O. So, substituting 30 minus 15 divided by logarithmic of 30 by 15 equal to 21.64 degrees Celsius. The next question from 2014 question paper. In a heat exchanger, it is observed that delta T1 equal to delta T2, where delta T1 is the temperature difference between two single phase fluid stream. Delta T2 is the temperature difference at the other end. The heat exchanger is a condenser, evaporator, a counter flow heat exchanger and a parallel flow heat exchanger. Now listen to the delta T1 is equal to delta T2. Delta T1 is the temperature difference between the two single phase fluids at the inlet and delta T2 is at the other end. So definitely this is not the condenser or the evaporator. So because the delta T1, delta T2 they are equal. So it may be a counter flow heat exchanger or a parallel flow heat exchanger. So the correct answer is counter flow heat exchanger. So we will see how, we will see the explanation in the next slide. Look at here. So this is the temperature profile for the parallel flow heat exchanger. This is the temperature profile for the counter flow heat exchanger. So the fluid for the parallel flow, both fluid entering on the left side, leaving on the right side. Whereas for the counter flow, hot fluid enters on the left side, leaves at the right side. Cold fluid enters on the right side and leaves at the left side. So delta T1 is equal to delta T2 for a counter flow heat exchanger provided the heat capacities are equal. So CC equal to CH. CC is mass of the cooling water and the specific heat of the cooling water, and CH is the mass of the hot water into specific heat of the hot water. When these two are equal, so delta T1 equal to delta T2 for counter flow heat exchanger. The next question from 2015 question paper. Saturated vapor is condensed to saturated liquid in a condenser. The heat capacity ratio is CR equal to C minimum by C maximum. The effectiveness of condenser is, we have the four equations. The correct answer is D, option D, 1 minus exponential of minus NTU. So, NTU is the number of transfer unit, UA by C minimum. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, there is a derivation. Normally, the derivation will be available in the theory video lecture. Anyhow, for the convenience of the reader, the students, I present the derivation here, the derivation for effectiveness of the condenser. And the heat transfer in the heat exchanger in differential form. So, for the cold fluid, dQc equal to mCcpc dTc. So, mCcpc is the heat capacity, capital CC into dTc. Similarly, dQh equal to minus mHcpH dTh, that is equal to minus Ch into dTh. So, the negative sign indicates there is decrease in temperature of the hot fluid. So, we have Q, heat transfer, dQ equal to UA into U delta T into dA. So, dQc, heat loss by the cold fluid is, heat gain by the cold fluid is equal to heat loss by the hot fluid, that is equal to U delta T into dA. Now, we take the d delta T. So, differentiate delta T. So, dTh minus dTc. So, d delta T equal to dTh from this equation, from the heat transfer equation, we substitute. So, this dTh minus dTc equal to minus dQ into 1 plus 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. So, d delta T equal to dQ equal to, we take from this equation, U delta T dA. So, U delta T dA into 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. So, we rearrange d delta T by delta T equal to minus u 1 by CH plus 1 by CC into dA. Now, integrating this equation, we'll get logarithmic of delta T2 divided by delta T1. So, delta T2 is the temperature difference on the right side, end of the heat exchanger, and delta T1 is at the entry of the heat exchanger. This is equal to minus UA into 1 by CH plus 1 by CC. So, this is the temperature difference, ratio of the temperature difference. Now, we take a parallel flow heat exchanger. So, for parallel flow heat exchanger, delta T1, temperature on the entry, THI minus TCI, and delta T2 equal to THO minus TCO. We assume the minimum heat capacity is for the hot fluid, C minimum equal to CH. So, substituting in this equation, logarithmic of delta T2 THO minus TCO divided by THI minus TCI equal to minus UA into 1 by C minimum plus C maximum. So, CH is considered as a C minimum value and C is the C maximum value. We take the equation to the next slide. So, here the same equation is repeated here. Left hand side as it is, right hand side we modify. We take denominator C minimum outside. So, minus UA by C minimum equal to 1 plus C minimum by C maximum. Now, UA by C minimum equal to NTU. So, number of transfer unit equal to UA by C minimum. So, minus NTU into 1 plus C minimum by C maximum equal to CR, the ratio of the heat capacity. So, to remove the logarithm, we take the exponential. So, THO minus TCO divided by THI minus TCI equal to exponential of minus NTU plus 1 plus CR. Now, we calculate C minimum by C maximum, the ratio C minimum by C maximum. C minimum by C maximum equal to CR. So, CR equal to MHCPH divided by MCCPC. So, we assume for the hot fluid, the specific heat is, heat capacity is minimum. So, the MHCPH divided by MCCPC equal to TCO minus TCI divided by THI minus THO. So, cross multiplication will give the correct answer. So, the amount of heat loss by the hot fluid is equal to amount of heat gained by the cold fluid. Now, from this expression, we calculate TCO. TCO equal to TCI plus C minimum by C maximum into THI minus THO, which is equal to TCO equal to TCI plus the ratio is CR into THI minus TCO. Now, in this equation, we substitute the TCO. So, THO minus TCO divided by THI minus TCI, I take the left hand side and I rearrange THO minus 1 by THI plus 1 by THI minus TCO, adding THI and subtracting THI, denominator as it is. Now, for the TCO, I substitute this value. So, THO minus THI plus THI minus TCI minus TCI minus CR into THI minus THO divided by THI by THI minus TCI. I take the final equation to the next slide. So, this is the previous, from the previously, now we rearrange THO minus TCO divided by THI minus TCI equal to 1 by 1. THO minus THI divided by THI minus TCI plus THI minus TCI divided by THI minus TCI minus CR into THI minus THO divided by THI minus TCI. So, the ratio is minus epsilon. So, why minus epsilon? Numerator we have to change. THI minus THO. So, minus epsilon. This is 1. So, plus 1. And again, here again, minus CR into, again, this value. THI minus THO divided by THI minus TCI is the effectiveness epsilon. So, finally, THO minus TCO divided by THI minus TCI equal to 1 minus epsilon into 1 plus CR. So, the ratio, we have this ratio. What is the ratio? The ratio is exponential of minus NTU into 1 plus CR. So, for parallel flow heat exchanger, minus 1 minus epsilon into 1 plus CR equal to exponential of minus NTU into 1 plus CR. So, rearranging, effectiveness of the parallel flow heat exchanger is 1 minus exponential of minus NTU into 1 plus CR divided by 1 plus CR. CR is the ratio of the specific heat capacity. Now, we take the condenser. For condenser, C maximum equal to infinity. So, when C maximum equal to infinity, CR equal to 0. So, in this equation, you substitute CR equal to 0 and you will get effectiveness equal to 1 minus exponential of minus NTU. So, this is the condenser, effectiveness of the condenser. So, the answer what is given is fourth option, it is correct answer. So, this is the derivation for the effectiveness of the heat exchanger in terms of NTU and the heat capacity ratio. The next question from 2016 question paper, for a heat exchanger delta T max, the maximum temperature difference, and the delta T minimum is the minimum temperature difference between the two fluids. LMTD is the log mean temperature difference. C minimum and C maximum are the minimum and the maximum heat capacities. The maximum possible heat transfer between the two fluids. Maximum possible heat transfer. So, in the design of effectiveness NTU method, we discussed T maximum equal to THI minus TCI. So, the maximum temperature difference. So the heat transfer will be maximum, the option B, C minimum into delta T max. So C minimum into delta T max is the correct answer for the maximum possible heat transfer between the two fluids. The next question from 2017 question paper, saturated steam at 100 degrees Celsius condenses on the outside of the tube. The cold fluid enters the tube at 20 degrees Celsius and leaves at 50 degrees Celsius. The value of LMTD in degrees Celsius. Again, the condenser. So, this is the temperature profile of the condenser. So, the given data for the condenser, THO equal to 100 degrees Celsius, TCA equal to 20 degrees Celsius, TCO equal to 50 degrees Celsius, theta I, THI minus TCA equal to 80 degrees Celsius, TCO, THO minus TCO equal to 50 degrees Celsius, and LMTD is theta I minus theta O divided by logarithmic of theta I by theta O, substituting 80 minus 50 divided by logarithmic of 80 by 50 equal to 63.82 degree Celsius. So the answer is 63.82 degree Celsius. The next question from 1997 question paper, in certain heat exchanger, both the fluid have identical mass flow and specific heat product. Heat capacities are equal. The hot fluid enters at 76 degrees Celsius and leaves at 47 degrees Celsius. And the cold fluid entering at 28 degrees Celsius, leaving at 55 degrees Celsius. The effectiveness of the heat exchanger is, we have four options, 0.16, 0.58, 0.72 and 1.0. And we calculate. So, Cc equal to Ch, that is what given. THI is 76, THO is 47, TCI equal to 28 and TCO equal to 55. And the epsilon for the hot fluid, effectiveness of the hot fluid, for the hot fluid, THI minus THO divided by THI minus TCI. So, 76 minus 47 divided by 76 minus 28 equal to 0.604 with respect to hot fluid. And effectiveness with respect to cold fluid, TCO minus TCI divided by THI minus TCI, 55 minus 28 divided by 76 minus 28, it is 0.5625. And the value here, which is closer to the calculated value, is 0.58. So, 0.58 is the correct answer. The next question from 2000 question paper, air enters a counterflow heat exchanger at 70 degrees Celsius and leaves at 40 degrees Celsius. Water enters at 30 degrees Celsius and leaves at 50 degrees Celsius. The LMTD is in degrees Celsius, 5.65, 14.43, 19.52, 20.17. And this is the counterflow heat exchanger. So, for counterflow heat exchanger, we draw the temperature profile. So, the hot fluid is entering left side and leaving on the right side. Cold fluid entering in the right side and leaving in the left side. Now, we have to calculate THI equal to 70, THO equal to 40, TCI equal to 30, TCO equal to 50, delta T1, temperature in the left side, THI minus TCO equal to 20 degrees Celsius, THI minus TCO equal to 70 minus 50 equal to 20 degrees Celsius, and delta T2, temperature difference at the right side, THO minus TCI, that is equal to 10. So, THO is 40 minus 30 equal to 10. So, now LMTD equal to theta I minus theta O divided by logarithmic of theta I by theta O. So, theta I is the delta T1, theta O is the delta T2. Substituting 20 minus 10 divided by logarithmic of 20 by 10 equal to 14.43 degree Celsius. So, the answer is option B, 14.43 degree Celsius. The next question from 2003 question paper. So, in a counterflow heat exchanger, the hot fluid heat capacity is 2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, mass flow rate is 5 kilogram per second, the inlet temperature is 150 degrees Celsius and the outlet temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. For the cold fluid, the heat capacity is 4 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, mass flow rate is 10 kilograms per second, inlet temperature is 20 degrees Celsius, the outlet temperature of the cold fluid. We have 4 answers, 7.5, 32.5, 45.5 and 70 degrees Celsius. Now, the given data, MH 5 kilogram per second, CPH 2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, MC 10 kilograms per second, CPC 4 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, THI 150 degrees Celsius, THO 100 degrees Celsius and TCI equal to 20 degrees Celsius. Now, the basic principle for the heat exchanger design, heat gained by the cold fluid is equal to heat lost by the hot fluid. So, substituting heat transfer equation, MC, CPC, TCO minus TCI equal to MH, CPH, THI minus THO. So, So substituting numerical values, 10 into 4 into TCO minus 20 equal to 5 into 2 into 150 minus 50. So solving this equation, TCO equal to 32.5 degree Celsius. So the answer is 32.5 degree Celsius. The next question from 2004 question paper. In a condenser, water enters at 30 degrees Celsius, flows at a rate of 1500 kilograms per hour. The condensing steam is at a temperature of 120 degrees Celsius and the cooling water leaves the condenser at 80 degrees Celsius. The specific heat of water is 4.178 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. The overall heat transfer coefficient is 2000 watts per meter square Kelvin. The heat transfer area we have to calculate for the condenser. There are four options here and the correct answer is 0.707 meter square. And we'll see how in the next slide we calculate here. So we write down all the given data. So MC equal to 1500 kilograms per hour, which is 0.417 kilograms per second. CPC equal to 4.187 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Overall heat transfer coefficient 2000 watts per meter square Kelvin. THI equal to THO equal to 120 degrees Celsius. And TCI equal to 30 degrees Celsius. TCO equal to 80 degrees Celsius. Then theta I, THI minus TCI equal to 90 degrees Celsius. And theta O equal to THO minus TCO equal to 40 degrees Celsius for the condenser. Now the heat transfer. Q equal to MCPC into TCO minus TCI. So 0.417 into 4.187 into 80 minus 30 equal to 87.3 kilojoules per second. Now this is the temperature profile of the heat exchanger. We calculate the LMTD. So LMTD equal to theta I minus theta O divided by logarithmic of theta I by theta O, which is 90 minus 40 divided by logarithmic of 90 by 40 equal to 61.66 degree Celsius. Now the heat transfer area, so area equal to Q by U into LMTD. So 87.3 in kilojoules per second. So overall heat transfer coefficient is also substituted in kilojoules per kilowatts per meter square in kilowatts per meter square. So U equal to 2 into LMTD equal to 61.66. So area is 0.707 meter square. The next question from 2005 question paper, hot oil is cooled from 80 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius in an oil cooler which uses air as the coolant. The air temperature rises from 30 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius. The designers uses LMTD value of 26 degree. The type of heat exchanger is parallel flow, counter flow, double pipe and cross flow. So the double pipe is not correct. Either it may be parallel flow, counter flow or cross flow. So the correct answer is cross flow heat exchanger. We will discuss the reason how in the next slide. So the values are given. THI 80 degrees Celsius, THO 50 degrees Celsius, TCI 30 degrees Celsius, TCO 40 degrees Celsius and LMTD is 26 degrees Celsius. And this is the temperature profile of the parallel flow heat exchanger. We calculate delta T1 50 degrees Celsius, delta T2 10 degrees Celsius. Then we calculate the LMTD, which is delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by logarithmic of delta T1 by delta T2, which is 50 minus 10 divided by logarithmic of 50 by 10 equal to 24.5 degree Celsius. And this is the temperature profile of the counter flow heat exchanger. So delta T1 is the temperature difference on the left side, delta T2 is the temperature difference on the right side. So for counter flow heat exchanger, delta T1, THI minus TCO, 80 minus 40 equal to 40 degree Celsius. Delta T2, THO minus TCI, 50 minus 30 equal to 20 degrees Celsius. Now, LMTD equal to 40 minus 20 divided by logarithmic of 40 by 20, which is 28.85 degrees Celsius. So, the value what is used by the designer is 26 degrees Celsius. It is greater than parallel flow, less than the counter flow LMTD value. So, this is the cross flow heat exchanger. So, the cross flow, for cross flow heat exchanger, the LMTD value of counter flow heat exchanger used to be multiplied by the factor F. So, F you have to take from the graph. So, the LMTD, the value represent, it is a counter flow heat exchanger. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in the mechanical engineering subject. You may find a book on heat and mass transfer. You may refer to it for additional information on the subject. And I upload the video lectures on the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. Use the videos for your better preparation and pass in the GATE examination. Thank you for watching. You please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again in another video on the solution on the GATE question paper in heat exchanger.